Well, the problem comes up right away that assuming that your customers expected you to pay in a perfectly rational way, nobody would have been willing to pay you a fee zero in the first year, knowing that you're planning on cutting your price to fee one in the second year. So what happens then is that in the first year, you would have faced a demand curve that actually becomes horizontal to level fee one. It would be downward sloping below that, and then up here in the second demand would just kind of disappear. But now, the problem gets worse than that because let's say that you actually do sell this much land in period one. Well, then you have this much land left over as residual, facing a residual marginal revenue from that, MR2. You would then be motivated to offer this much additional land to 2 units. In the following year, the price of which would be T2. And then you got the same problem. You're kind of chasing your tail all this way because not only would the first year people never have been willing to buy the T0, knowing that it was going to drop to T1 in the next year, people never will buy for T1, knowing that it's going to drop to T2 a year after that. And it keeps going so that this year's people, T2, are going to rationally expect that you're going to do that again. Another marginal revenue, MR3, will come into play. The only place where this stops is where the price finally meets marginal cost. That is the competitive equilibrium. In other words, this price you might call PN is the only price where anybody's going to be willing to buy anything. With any price above that, everybody would expect, though, next year is going to be cutting it, we'll buy it this year, and we'll buy it next year instead. So here's the confusing result about the post-conjecture thing, but to this day, and yet, you're thinking, your common sense is going to come back and say,